said that he found Atreus familiar. Perhaps they met in Jotunheim.
Perhaps so, brother. We'll have to ask the lad for that story when we next see him.
Mimir, there's something I wanted to ask you about. Hildesvini told me about your visit to secure Hel's army, but was reluctant to elaborate when it came to negotiating with Hrasfelder.
Enough talk for now. Be ready.
Thanks for grabbing that for us.
What is wrong?
No, nothing. It's just, don't know if you've heard, but we're gonna say goodbye to Brock in Svartalfheim.
A funeral?
Yeah. We're meeting at Rab's Tavern in Nidavellir.
We will be there.
Hell of a job you did at Ragnarok, General. Wish I could have been there to see you and Sindri take down Thor and Odin.
That is not what happened.
Yeah. Maybe not, but it's the story I like best. Important thing is, Odin's paid in full for what he did to Brock. I know it doesn't fix what's broke, but it ain't nothing.
Hello, Lunda.
Hey, goddess. About your brother. I never got the chance to tell you. I know moments like this you're supposed to say sorry and whatnot, but always known that pretty man had greatness in him. That he'd do something amazing one day, and I'm just... You know, I'm proud that now the Nine Realms know it too.
I thank you.
Anytime, ma'am.
I came by and took out an Einherjar patrol. Area should be clear. Can't speak for the rest of town.
Guess an occupying army is as good as a lockdown for tamping down foot traffic.
Profane alternate lyrics to my ballads. Absolutely disgusting. wish I could remember some of them.
The paperwork that man created for me. I had to build a chest just for his violations. A big one.
I taught him 20 different ways to cold forge a bolster. Once, he taught me a slightly easier method of wire pulling, and from that day on, called me his apprentice.
A true asshole he was. Gods, I'm gonna miss him.
Aye. Y'all made it. Just about to send him off.
I have met many on my travels. You are one of the few I would call friend.
I always thought you were one of the dumbest creatures I'd ever met. Didn't expect you to be the bravest, too.
This world is a darker place for your leaving it.
We're taking him to the Sverd Sands. It's, in the wetlands near the ferry. We'll wait for you there.
Another raven sent to the Tree of the Dead. Perhaps we should check up on it, hmm?
Damn it.
What is wrong?
I should have changed. Sewn some mourning garb. We're not dressed properly.
We're fine. Dwarves don't typically require formal wear at funerals.
Brock certainly would not.
Perhaps.
So, now you've got me thinking of what I might look like with some jewelry around my neck stump. Maybe some gold woven into my beard. That'd be quite fetching, eh?
Thanks for trying.
There they are, brother.
Oh, come on, surely he'll be along. It's his brother.
Let's hope so. Loss can do things to a man. You made it. We can begin. love you.
Sindri. Blackpuss.
It's bigger, the more you take away.
To all things housed in her silence, nature offers a violence. The bear that keeps to his own line.
I don't know if there's anything beyond the light. Afterlives after afterlives or what have you. But if there is, I imagine he's causing one crazy ruckus there.
I wrote that dirge for him.
What's it called?
Something profane.
He wouldn't have it any other way.
Forgive Sindri. He's just, I mean, you know.
When Jormungandr attacked Thor in Asgard, it seemed personal somehow. But there's no way they could have met before that, is there?
I've been pondering that, and I have a theory. We know the lad spent his time in Jotunheim learning soul magic. Perhaps the serpent figured in.
You mean Atreus placed some other giant soul into him? Someone who already hated Thor to begin with?
Exactly! Though that doesn't narrow it down much, I grant you. I wonder if Jormi even remembers after all this time who he once was.
I hope you're back to clean up the mess that extra head of yours made.
We have done it.
In addition to destroying Asgard and ending Odin's rule, so you're welcome.
Your hammer.
Thank you. With Odin gone, this will be a nice reminder to folks.
Of what?
That we didn't give up. And we won. Never expected to see this thing again. I suppose more violence in the streets will convince the citizenry that it's safe to emerge.
Freya, something is on your mind. What is it?
Freyr's sword. I'm glad he got it back.
Odin stole it?
Not quite. It couldn't be stolen. It had to be given freely. Freyr had it forged in his younger days, imbued with its own motives and passion. For centuries, he swore he would only ever set it down in death or upon meeting the love of his life. Both he and the sword were romantics, you see.
Here.
Sparkthorn.
is gone.
So they say. Hence the state of teetotaling perfection you see before you. The man before you is as sober as the day he was born.
You are still drinking.
This is goat's milk.
It is brown.
It was an ugly goat. Look, the point is, it actually happened. A man lives with a boot on their face long enough, they lose hope their cheeks will ever feel the same. None of us ever really thought we'd get rid of Odin. That we did, and that you helped. Well, it's not something anyone's likely to forget.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, same to you.
See which armpit of Muspelheim that seems to do, huh?
Muspelheim. I thought the climate would be pleasant after Midgard's winter. I was wrong.
Aye, but it's a dry heat.
Shop I'm running out in the Alfheim Desert, there's something y'all are probably gonna want to see.
An ash petal.
What do you know of the trials?
From what I hear, Surtur set up a bunch of combat challenges to test his weapons and whatnot. Better you are at fighting, the better the rewards. You know the drill.
Lunda.
Hi there. I wanted to ask, do you want me to stop talking about your muscles and how you look and stuff? Because it seems like it's making you all wiggly, like in a bad way.
It did, but no longer.
Oh, okay. So I should stop? Sounds like I should stop.
No.
Oh, all right, handsome. Your beefcake? If I look like that, I'd stand around and just let folks stare too.
I look forward to exploring Alfheim and not having to fight elves.
Oh? What makes you think that's an option?
They've united, haven't they? What possible reason would they have to attack us?
Sorry to say, but there are still plenty of elves out in the Barrens eager for conflict.
But why? Freyr united them. They fought together at Ragnarok.
For those who have... spent their lives in combat. Peace is not always an option.
Thank you. Get her!
Another of Cavassier's poems.